consumer. The Google's Apples is a company that we know is looking at different possibilities here, along with LG, Samsung, and a lot of other household names. So we're looking forward to lots of discussion. And with that, I'd like to bring Alexander up and hear his perspectives.
Okay. So everybody, I hope everybody can listen to me because I don't have these mobile microphones, but it doesn't matter. I can stay here. So first of all, thank you very much for inviting me again to this conference. For those guys who might know me, I've already had a little speech last year. My name is Alexander Pippert. I'm the head of Innovation Center for Smart Home, not only for Germany, but for the whole E.ON group. So my topic with my team is on two things. One is that we are looking for disruptive technologies around the smart and connected home. And the second topic we have is we will deliver great products on this technology today and in future. So it's not a technology-driven topic which we pursue here for the E.ON group. It's also a product development speedboat we have being set up for this now. And last year, I've been here only with charts and PowerPoints because last year we started and this year is our second year. And I'm very happy that I've brought some hardware to that table, which we have tested with customers in a real sales environment. So we are quite happy that until now we have seven different projects in three countries running with technology partners, guys similar to Passive Systems, but also with customers where we believe the real value is and where the growth story for smart home starts. From these seven trials, we have also launched two products commercially wise, one in Germany in May and one in UK in July. And I will give you some insights on how these trials went during that speech. But let me start the story where we come from as an E.ON group. Maybe that is working now better, Colin. I don't know. I try again. One. No. Okay. Again, one. Okay. That's a little summary of our business approach, which I have also presented last year. That's the business approach we are currently testing. So the mission of E.ON in the smart home is really, let's say, to be a leading provider of smart energy applications on open platforms. So that means that we have so far not decided to create own platforms or own gateways. We think that other companies can do this better. But we are good in developing applications which will enable to integrate the customer power need, power production, heat need, heat production with the grid. So we aim for to position ourselves as a system integrator, which actually has then two customers. One is the customers who owns the building, and the other customers is the grid and the energy system. Therefore, it's a system integration between customer needs and system needs. And we are focusing our internal contribution on developing intelligent algorithm, managing the PV consumption in the home, depending on the grid demand, for example, managing heat pumps, aggregating heat pumps to virtual power plants. So this is what we are currently striving for. So not producing hardware, producing software, and we are aiming for really looking for great algorithms. And the approach how we are going to do this currently is we have an innovation tunnel in our team, which goes from the left to the right, obviously. We have different ideas. We take them into our prioritization group. So we do a technical product development, then we do some R&D trials with friendly users. Then we do a proposition development, which means that we make a product out of this, take it to the market, test it whether it's successful. And once it's successful, then we achieved our goal, then it's already, it has a go-to-market ability. And we do this in parallel. So that means that because we are convinced that this speeds up our learning, that, for example, with the home energy management products, which you know that most of these products are ready, you can buy them from the market, the software is ready, and you just can sell them to the customers. This is the pathway number one. So most of these products, we take them directly from the market and test them with customers, whether they fly or not. And with more complicated products and more sophisticated products, we develop our own algorithms and software on this. So this is by this dual approach, we are convinced that we can win the race for the smart home, which we think is a very competitive market already. The question is, where do we stand now within our projects and our trials so far? On the next page, which takes a second, but it will come. Okay, here we go. This is the same innovation tunnel you have seen from the last page, but here you see the projects which we have set up now, and this is the status of the projects which we have. So on the upper side, you see there our current project with the Deutsche Telekom on the KiwiCon platform together, which is a project where we as E.ON develop by ourselves a great home energy management software which will be deployed on the platform. And it's currently in technical product development. We have not tested it with friendly users so far. On the other side, on the upper right, from your perspective, you see there our first E.ON eHome product, which we have launched this year in Germany together with our partner Telefunken. And behind there is a little software company from the southern part of Germany called MSR. And that package actually, we did the packaging, we did a bit changes in the dashboard, but the main goal for that project was to really test customer experience with this, to test it with real prices, test different sales channels, to understand how we can deliver such a product to a customer, that customer would really buy this. The same we did on the lower right, we did with the home energy management product we built together with the company called GreenWave Reality. It's another partner of us delivering platforms and devices, such you will see later. And this is again a sales trial which we are currently conducting in the region of Manchester and Nottingham in the UK. And with the GreenWave platform before this trial, we tested and did a fairly large friendly user test in Milton Keynes. I think most of you know this city. It's 100 kilometers, 1 hour away in the north from London. And that friendly users tested these products together with us, looked for potential benefits for them. And I will talk today, because we're talking about hands-on experiences with home energy management, I will talk today only about this friendly user test in Milton Keynes. Otherwise, it would take me probably the whole day to talk about these trials. There are other trials we are doing, and this is more the more complex algorithms we are developing currently, an algorithm which manages the photovoltaic together with different appliances for, let's say, maximizing the own consumption for a customer. And we have a project in Sweden which aims to manage the different appliances by smart tariffs. So let's look for now only at the Milton Keynes trial, what we did there and what we found out, because the results are fairly interesting and this is real customer experience. So in Milton Keynes, this trial is still ongoing. It's a fairly long project. It will run until end of next year. And during that year, we will test different home energy management propositions with these friendly users. We so far managed to recruit 75 fairly average friendly users, households, as you see, participants across Milton Keynes in different regions, typically homeowners in existing properties, mixture of families and single households, to really have some average man, woman, and children there. You see this here on the right side. Represents more or less the UK average household there. Most have above average builds, basic home energy management system proven in field trials for over 9 months now. We are quite happy to have these friendly users because we really can take them as a co-developer for our products. And the trial is still ongoing and we will upgrade the system step by step. So these are the users, fairly average users. Nothing, let's say, really unusual there. And the product we have tested there so far, you see this on the next slide in a second. I would like to present you first the product before I come to the result. Let's say we are ongoing testing different features on that GreenWave platform, but I would like to talk only about the first two steps in that trial where we tested a home gateway, an in-home display, two of these plugs which can measure and can control different appliances. These are, I mean, you know them, they are quite common now in the world. We tested this gateway here. This is quite small actually, and it connects with an Ethernet cable to your broadband router, works with the Z-Wave and different other protocols. And we have tested this kind of display, whether this is useful for customers, and you can look at it and understand your current energy demand. We have also tested the smartphone app, which we co-created with GreenWave together, and a web portal. So these are the four, or basically five, items we have tested. And the users receive first the monitoring function. So first they only receive the gateway and the display and the application on the smartphone and the web portal. And then in the second step, they receive two of these control plugs, because we wanted to test the difference between only understanding energy consumption and the question of controlling different appliances. What is more useful and what is the relative comparison of each? But the one of the biggest questions we had is, will the customer change their behavior, and what is the trigger behind? Because as a utility, of course, we are looking for features where we can influence customer behavior to manage their load, to, you know, integrate them into the fluctuating energy systems, of course. So this is quite important for us to understand. They also got a little energy manager to help them installing the system and helping them guiding through the software. And I would like to give you a first insight into that video, the energy coach, which we have
Welcome
invented, how it
E.ON
looks like.
Energy management system. We have provided you with a set of powerful tools to increase awareness of your energy use and allow you greater control over your home. As your energy coach, I will guide you through this journey and make suggestions to help you become more energy aware. We will track your progress together using the E.ON Energy Passport. As you learn more about your energy management system, your progress and accomplishments will be rewarded with stamps in your passport, which can also be shared with your friends via Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. Have you ever wondered how much energy you are using right now? Am I using more or less energy than usual? How much did today cost me? Which devices in my home are costing me the most? What can I do about it? Your E.ON energy management system will answer these questions by showing your overall electricity and gas use at a glance. It will even tell you how much that load of washing cost you yesterday. You can see how much you are using compared to your average, track your budget, and see your estimated costs in real time. You'll gain a better understanding of how even small changes in behavior can make big differences in consumption. How does your energy use compare to others like you? How much room for improvement do you have? You can explore how your energy consumption compares with households like yours. This helps give you some perspective on how others are doing, allows you to monitor your progress, and can also show you where you have an opportunity to improve. Your E.ON coaching program is designed to give you what you need to reduce your energy use, save money, and easily make the most of this system. You can always see the next steps in your journey when you visit the My Energy screens. Simply click to get started, and I'll guide you through each activity. From time to time, E.ON will also have some messages for you. A small red bubble will appear on the button in the lower right of the overview screen to let you know there are ones that you have not yet read. The My Energy section contains the entire coaching program, which gives you greater detail about your current activities, allows you to explain.
Okay, thank you. Because it takes quite long, and I don't want to show you now for 30 minutes the whole video. Can we go back to the PowerPoint presentation? That, because usually it should work with the, no? Otherwise we can continue watching the video. But I wanted to give you the answer from our research question. It's not very good. So this is also what the customer received as a little software tool in order to really install the system and use the system for the energy coach. But the real question is, have they changed on their behavior based on that hardware pack and the software you have seen? And the result is unfortunately not be possible to illustrate. Okay. So the result is, I can possibly continue then. The result is that...
Here we go.
Okay, yeah. Yes. Yes, they have changed their, let's say, energy behavior due to these components they have received from us. However, it differs a lot by the different displays, smartphone apps, and web portals. So it differs a lot by the kind of device and the kind of, I would say, handset and screen and information insight they get. For example, what you see here is that overall, and this is regardless before they have received the smart plugs or after they have received the smart plugs, that the in-home display is not working quite well, because also after they have received the smart plugs, 78 or 66% of the users said, this is not useful for me, or in other words, that information I've seen on that display does not change my energy behavior. And it's a lot different when you're looking on the web portal, where you see both in the scenario with the smart plugs or without the smart plugs, that most of the friendly users say yes. The information which I've seen in the web portal really influences my behavior in using power or gas. So for us, as a conclusion here, is that we will not possibly, you know, work with the displays anymore. The smartphone app is quite nice. However, the information we currently display is not sufficient enough that consumers change their behavior. I have to say that our web portal is really sophisticated, and users get a lot of information, as you have seen in the video. So a web portal is something which customers use, and based on that information, they change their behavior. However, the significance of their behavior change is very low. This is illustrated on the next slide. So it has been significantly in specific areas, but significant in some and minimal in others. Overall, I can say that the consumers expected that by this system they can reduce their energy bills a lot. It's still a key driver for most of the consumers to reduce energy bills. For the most, the potential reduction in consumption of electric appliances doesn't justify the convenience trade-off. We had a friendly user who said, now I understand how much electricity my micro oven really uses, unexpectedly high, but I will not stop using it because otherwise I have to cook in the oven, I don't want it. And on the other side, the cost they can really save when they, I would say, change their energy behavior, don't break the bank. For customers or for these users, it was really worth to use their washing machine for 50 euro cent. So there was a change in behavior, but it was very minimal, significant in some areas, but overall it was very minimal. On the other side, the kind of change in behavior really dropped in the monitoring function. On the left side, you see here that once consumers have learned about the consumption profiles from their appliances or from their smart meter, they have understood it, then they have changed their behavior in some areas, but overall then the engagement level drops very, very quickly, whereas they, after they have received the control function with these smart plugs, they keep their engagement level a bit more higher, right? So they are playing with it around, they are, you know, programming their kettle when they go out with the dog so that the tea is hot when they come back. It was really quite interesting use cases we got there. So it's a bit higher, but overall the level of engagement drops really, really significantly after they've understood what the system does for them. It gets boring quite significantly. This means for us, one conclusion is that we have to drive the engagement by making a proactive system rather than a reactive one. This is what we tested is very reactive. It is interesting maybe in the first second, but it's getting very boring after a couple of days. these plugs again can hold the engagement level a bit better, but still there will be a time where they will drop very soon. What we need are alerts, algorithms, and awareness, a system which makes proposals, a system which detects alarms, something which is not passive. And another conclusion is that within power and power savings on appliances, I would say without time and use tariffs, it is very, very difficult to find their really good use cases. In heating, it's possibly better. So we are currently testing a heating device with the friend users, and our friend users have told us that there is the real carrot, because the heating for them breaks the trade-off and the critical question between, okay, maybe then I can save heating costs, but also can increase the comfort, because maybe then they can have some thermostats in rooms where they haven't one, so the room is warm, and they have the energy costs under control. So that could be a case where we are currently thinking has more value for customers. Overall, I have to say that based from that understanding from one of our 7 trials, we conclude that transparency alone is not the killer. I would say it's needed as a basis, but that data illustration is just boring for customers, and I think nobody is paying for it. With smart plugs, the home energy management gets more appealing, okay, but the level of engagement drops also with these plugs very quickly. So from this study, my key messages is two. The one is customers will buy these products if they save money, and ideally we can guarantee these savings to them, and then this is a good product. Or they substantially increase the comfort, and I mean, turning the light on from outside the home is not a comfort increase, it's just, from my point of view, useless. But they increase substantially the comfort and save some money in the same time, which could be the heating, in markets where the heating systems maybe are not so advanced as we might have in other markets. And Nest has proven this. I mean, if you all know the intelligent thermostat from California, the Nest system, you know, customers has bought this system because it has increased their comfort, saved some money, and looks great. So this is how it worked. On top of this, I have to say there are 3 other factors to unlock the mass market. It's not only the product, it's also the go-to market, the product placement and promotion. This is absolutely crucial for that, for the home energy management. The best sales tool are other customers. I strongly believe in the C2C approach, where customers sell the systems to other customers, community-based stories, good examples, and the revenues from B2C sales will not cover the marketing costs. So if you believe that with these systems you make money as a utility in the, or as a telco or whatever kind of provider in the first years, you have to spend so many marketing costs to find that customer who will buy it, it will not cover or the revenues will not cover the cost. So this is where we are based on that trial. For us, quite good insights. I was quite happy to share this with you. And I'm looking to forward to the discussion later in the panel, what the views of you are on this. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Thank you very much, Alexander.